So you've never been deployed before. Okay, that's fine. Don't worry. I got tips for you. You're going to need them. And you're going to need to see them now. Sit down. Let's go. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Summer French. And on today's episode, here's the drill. I'm going to be giving you tips for deployment. Now, before I get started, make sure you smash that like button. If you like what you're seeing, comment below. I want to hear your tips for the deployments and help out these other enlisted soldiers or officers in here that need help with some tips on deployment. And tell you, don't miss an episode. Hit the subscribe button too. It's that easy. You're still here. Before I get started on tips, I just want to tell you, congratulations to you on taking on a deployment. It's easily one of the most difficult things to do in the United States military. It's going to challenge you up here. It's going to challenge your body. It's going to challenge you at home. It's going to challenge you. But like all challenges, you're going to grow as a leader. That I promise you. And you're going to enjoy it too. I promise you there's going to be some stuff you enjoy. Stay with me. Let's get into the tips. Here we go. Now for the first one, these are the ones that you're gonna do before you deploy. And what I'm gonna tell you is you need a power of attorney. Especially if you have a spouse, you have siblings, you have all this, you need a power of attorney. Even if you don't and you're just single, you're living in the barracks, doing what you gotta do, you need to get a power of attorney to allow your parents to handle some things just in case something happens back home and you can't be there, you got somebody to help you out. You need that. On to the next one, you need a hammock. Trust me, don't laugh. You need a hammock. Trust me, at some point, you're gonna fly in a C-130 or C-17 on your travels to wherever you're going forward, and you can have a hammock. But where can you use it? You can use it on all those connexes inside a C-130, and you can be the one hanging, sleeping real nice, instead of sleeping in that chair. Or if you know, the floor of a C-130 and C-17, ice cold, get a hammock. Next, day one, when you hit the ground on wherever you're being deployed to, you better start good habits. Start good habits right off the jump. Good habits with eating, good habits with sleeping, good habits with exercising, everything. How you form those habits on the first week is what's going to carry through the entire deployment. I promise you, if you were going over there to change your diet or change how you exercise or change how you do these things, day one is going to be key to you to create good habits. Next, save money. Save your money. If you don't have an abundance of money when you leave from a deployment, then I don't know what to tell you. You're not gonna be spending money on gas, the movies, the mall, none of this. You're gonna save money. Trust me when I say save some money, because the one thing that you should do, depending on how long your deployment is, 6, 8, 9 months, you should always plan for something that when you land, you have a cruise, you got a vacation, you're gonna get a new car, you're gonna do whatever. You need to get yourself something or your family something, and you need to start planning for that, as well as paying off your bills. Save your money. Your workout plan, you better have one. When you deploy, you should be in the best shape of your life when you leave. You have no excuses. You're gonna wake up, go to work, work out, eat, sleep. That's it. That's all you're gonna do. Basically the same thing as prison. They're usually in shape. I'm just saying, it's not prison though. Have a plan for your workout. Have a built-in rest day. Do things that are going to create a good habit. If you're going to the gym twice a day when you're deployed, that's not going to be it. You need to make sure that you're mission capable. But at the same time, what you need to do is have a workout plan that makes sense. Hey, on Wednesdays, I'm going to take off, but every other day, I'm going to do this, 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 and this. And then I'm going to elevate my reps. Then I'm going to get stronger here. Then I'm going to do more cardio here. Deployment. Best shape of your life. You better have it. Now, if you're going during the holidays, do one thing. It's going to help you out up here between the ears. When it gets to those holidays, Thanksgiving, Christmas, Easter, whatever your holiday is, stay off the social media. Stay off it. It's just going to rewind you back, bring you back, and it's going to set you back for what you're out there doing and having that bigger purpose in your life and the military. So for me, set up something with your soldiers. Set up something that you have planned of a feast with all these guys. We're going to get together. We're going to do this. Then I'm going to call home and FaceTime. Got that good. Whatever. Stay off the social. That's my tip. Stay off the social media for those days. Trust me, it'll be hard. It'll be worth it. Sunglasses. Yeah, you need good sunglasses. Not just glasses that you get at the gas station or Target or any of these places. No, a good pair of sunglasses. What makes it good? Polarized. You need your glasses to be polarized. If you are out somewhere in Kuwait, the Middle East, I'm telling you, the sun hits different. Promise you, it hits different. Your regular sunglasses, you're gonna walk around, sunglasses on, like this. Polarizing sunglasses. Get them. Next, you need a hard drive. You need an external hard drive for your laptop, for your iPad. Don't matter what it is, you need it. Why do you need it? Because you need to load it up with movies, shows, everything to watch. There may be times when you don't have Wi-Fi. There may be times when you don't have internet. You better load it up with stuff you've never seen, stuff that reminds you of home, stuff that you love that keeps you happy, stuff that puts you to sleep, all of it. You better load it up. Your hard drive is crucial. Rippets. That's it. Rippets, the energy drink. If you know, you know. That's a tip. Get them. Now, earlier in the episode, I talked about having a schedule and creating good habits. I need you every single day to expand your knowledge or your MOS. Put in an hour every single day. If you're not on mission, you're not outside the wire, you're not doing what you can, I need you to put 30 minutes to an hour in on your MOS or expanding your mind. Whether that's college, a new language, you're learning more about your MOS. I'm going to spend 45 minutes learning about this, an hour about... If you don't do it, no one will. And if you can't do it on a deployment when you have all the time, you're never going to do it. Have a plan for yourself on what you want to learn. And promise you, you'll learn it. That's it. Put it into a plan. You got this. And my last tip for deploying is appreciate everything. Appreciate the little things. Appreciate all the things that make this country one of the best countries in the world. When I got back from my first deployment, I appreciated grass so much. Laid down in grass because it was soft. I haven't walked on grass in eight months. Just to walk on grass, I appreciate that. Appreciate everything that you're able to do. You're able to go down the street, buy all the groceries you want. You could go down the street and drive to your friend's house. You can do everything. Appreciate the finer things that we have here in the United States of America, because when you go over there, you're going to see a different side of the world. A different side of the world that operates very different than us. And I'll tell you right now, I wish that the 99% of the population that doesn't leave this country, I wish they could see it, because they would appreciate this country a little more. So my tip to you is to appreciate the finer things and enjoy them. So those are my tips for deployment. What I want to hear from you is, what are your tips? Put them in the comments below. Put them in the comments. I want to hear from you, because these are the tips that are going to help our junior enlisted soldiers. They're going to help our NCOs. They're going to help our officers. They're going to help everybody push it up to the top and be the best that they can be. And I'll tell you what, you take these tips, you're going to be ahead of your peers. And today, y'all know.